Hello, and welcome to our playthrough of Horizon Forbidden West. I hope you're enjoying the series as much as I am, and now let's head into our episode.
Are you okay?
What happened?
We found something that will help. Not just your homeland, but everywhere.
But where's the CO?
Oh, he's dead.
Oh, he's gone. I guess you could say he gave his life to help us attain the secrets of Thebes.
That's stretching it.
I see. You must think I'm eminently stupid.
What? No. No.
The CEO was an entitled egotist who twisted our beliefs into a sickening, self-serving fantasy. And you expect me to believe he sacrificed himself for scraps of data?
Oh!
It's time for the truth, and it better be convincing.
Tell the truth.
Otherwise, I'll simply order these soldiers to open fire.
And kill them all.
Hold on. You're right. To be honest, the CEO screwed everything up. He brought Thebes down around our ears and died like a gutless coward.
That's what.
We really did find something down there that will help your homeland. If I can take it and use it. Now, if I have to, I will fight my way out of here, but it doesn't have to be that way. You can just let me go. And then take credit when things start to improve.
Success certainly does sound better than failure. It seems then that our destinies are intertwined. Landfall is open to you. If it will help your cause, you may come and go as you please. But Alva must join you and report back on your efforts.
Fair enough.
Thebes is of no further value to us. Obviously, we're going back to the flotilla. Alva, I expect your reports to be thorough.
Are we going
to
give her an upgraded focus? Definitely Polynesian.
Oh, I thought he was going to have us killed. Oh, and instead, I get to join you.
Yay.
Glad to have you. But you're going to need a little help to reach our base. Varl, I made a new friend. I need you to meet her at the Quen Ferry and escort her back.
On it. Can't wait to meet her.
Trust me, you'll love it there. Varl will give you a better focus and all the data you could ever want.
Half of which you won't like.
Head to the ferry. I'll join you back east as soon as I can.
A diviner must follow the truth, wherever it leads. I'll see you there.
Well, that was...
Now that I have Omega clearance, we should have what we need to capture Hephaestus. But before I head to the ferry, maybe I should stop by Landfall. With the CEO gone, maybe more Quen will be willing to talk.
Oh!
It might be worth looking around the island, too.
Okay.
I gotta change out of these clothes. I can't believe the CEO made me play dress-up.
Okay. Well, that implies... Let's head back to Landfall real quick. Discovered Pharaoh's fate. Also, can I change into my stuff? Sobek's raiment. Oh my god, it actually has stats. Not bad stats either, actually. I mean, definitely a blue. Not a bad blue, but we're gonna do. We were using Vindicator. No, Valiant. Go ahead and equip you. You. Question: how do I get up? Wow. Oh wow, there's a lot of boats. Look at that. They weren't kidding when they said flotilla, were they? Right, well. Ted is now hopefully dead? They can still bring him back, though. Ted has a big enough ego and, unfortunately, the know-how, and more importantly, the insanity. I bet you he put up a backup that if he died, a clone of himself would be created in a birthing chamber somewhere on Earth. They can still bring him back. And I'm hoping they do if they do bring him back, maybe they can play with the dynamic of nurture versus nature. I would love to see the Ted clone become a good person. Or maybe they just keep him an insane narcissist. Quests! Yay, quests! So I want to go back, but I'm afraid if I go back, it will trigger the main quest.
How? There's no way we can find our way back home like this.
I promise you, we'll find a way home.
Harriam. We're never getting that gyro compass back.
We're getting that gyro compass back.
For good.
The ancestor reborn.
May we be led to truth.
Just, Aloy, what's this I hear about you never going back home?
Our navigational ships.
They're all gone. Destroyed by storms and reefs, and with them the one instrument we need to guide us across the ocean.
Could use the stars.
There's one ship that might still hold a working gyro compass.
But it's beyond our reach, beached on an island surrounded by deadly currents. No compass, no way home, no way back to those we should have never left behind in the first place.
Christia.
You said what you need is on a ship somewhere.
Yes. The ship we were stationed on. The night we approached landfall, a sudden squall hit the fleet. While some ships managed to find safe harbor here, ours ran aground. The crew abandoned ship, hoping the ocean would spare us.
I thought we'd drown for sure. Thank the ancestors, we somehow got washed up on a beach southwest of here. Scouts found us and brought us to landfall. Not that it matters. The only ship with the gyro compass is grounded and surrounded by deadly currents.
So what is this gyro compass you're looking for?
It's a device used by the ancestors to help pinpoint a ship's location.
GPS.
It only works if the readings are compared to a chart.
How'd you get your hands on something like that?
I guess it's safe to tell you, since you carry the gift of the ancestors. The diviners found them on ancient vessels back in our homeland and modified them so we could use them on our ships. Without them, we're at the mercy of the seas.
Or you can use the stars. I'm just saying, that's a thing. And can still be done to modern day.
So you two are soldiers?
Navigators, actually. I'm Harriam, and this is Christia.
So you two know how to use this instrument?
The gyro compass. Only I know how to read it. The diviners trained me. Harriam was chosen to memorize the charts found in the legacy.
So you can't navigate the fleet without each other?
It is the Quen way.
That's
the
a bit
greater
weird.
The knowledge held by one person alone. The greater the risk it'll be used against the Empire, should we be captured by our enemies.
Your tribe sure is cautious.
But that implies they have enemies. Interesting.
You mentioned you left someone behind?
My, wife, Meandra.
Hey, representation.
She works the field in the Great Delta. When I was chosen for this mission, she begged me not to come. She was scared I wouldn't return. And like always, she was right. I left without saying goodbye, and now I won't ever see her again.
I'll fix that.
Maybe I can help.
Not unless you can fly.
I can't do that. But if I find a way, I'll come back.
That implies
an ancestor reborn. Maybe she really can help.
I will not let myself hope just yet, but I thank you for your kindness.
So that is the, I will say, third thing we found that implies at some point we're going to learn how to fly. How awesome is
that? I
don't
think I can get to that ship. At least, not now.
Ancestor, please. It's about my brother. I don't mean to disturb you, but I've run my requests through every channel and I've gotten nowhere.
Just take me through it.
Apologies. My name is Jomar. I'm the weapons officer for this expedition.
Ooh.
It's my job to ensure the troops are armed and prepared for what's out there.
Okay.
And I've failed to do so. My younger brother, Oris,
we're gonna do this real
quick. Was sent to scout the tower on the northern side of the island. They should have returned by now. The Overseer has denied my request for a search party, and defying him would mean dismissal, or worse.
You think they might be alive?
Oris has been obsessed with San Francisco ever since I can remember. He jumped at the chance to join this expedition. I have to believe that fate isn't cruel enough to make this place his tomb. If you help me, I'll get you access to any weapon in my stock.
If I make my way up north, I'll look for your brother.
Thank you.
We're doing this real quick.
My brother carried an ancestral relic with him. I believe your focus might be able to pick it up.
What kind of relic?
A small metal piece dangling from a chain with a hologram of San Francisco, which is why my brother always had it with him. The diviners speculated it was some kind of beacon inviting the ancestors to visit the city.
Speculated? So there was data on it they couldn't read.
It was deemed lost knowledge. If my brother truly is gone, could you maybe bring the relic back for me? It meant so much to Oris. I'd like to keep it safe. For him.
Of course.
Oh, we're doing this now. I want better weapon. Yeah. Oh, bollocks. Swim across, I guess? We've got the materials to do. Yeah, we should be fine. Wait a minute. Okay, I'm sorry. I was looking at the wrong.
You mind leaving me alone for a sec?
Yep, this way. Alright. We're gonna do this real quick.
Chin up, soldier. You've got a lot.
And then we'll see how much time I have left. And then we'll return to the base and hopefully I don't get locked into him. That's what I'm afraid of now, is getting locked into a mission I have to do. Alright, here's what we'll do. We'll do this quest, then we'll see how much time I got left, and then we'll go from there. I get the feeling we're probably going to finish this game up in the next few days. So, refresher, for those of you who watch live, the next game we play after this will be Warhammer 3, and I will be using mods. Probably not the mods I would like, but we will be using mods. Sunwings. Oh my god, are they in the tower? Alright. We're going for a swim. I bet you there's tons of loot down here. Really? Nothing? That would just scatter loot all over the place. Make it inviting. I don't want to come down here. I will say, honestly, that I hope in the next game they make it even, I'm not sure bigger is the word I want, but larger in scope, to the point of maybe we travel around the world and like recruit different tribes or something.
There, on the beach. A Quint scout. I need to get closer.
Wait, where?
See if he's carrying a relic like Jomar mentioned.
Where? Oh, over here. Okay, never mind. I was looking in the wrong spot.
Nothing. No relic. Can't be Jomar's brother.
Now, where are the others?
I should take a look around. See if I can find anyone else.
Your footsteps, they kind of lead off in all directions. Search the area for Quen scouts. Right. Sure. Okay, so it is on the beach. Other truckers. So the footsteps seem to go in this direction. I don't know why. What are we looking at?
I should check if one of them is Jomar's brother. But I'll need to get rid of those machines first.
Yeah. What's your path? No, not really. Get his attention. Needs to look at me. Really? Did it kill it? Oh. Alright, hold on. Maybe this kills it. Usually not. Definitely did more damage.
That'll get it off my back for a second.
Really? Oh, well, I mean, I'll take the glue. Alright, hold on. Hi! Thank you. Bite note. Oh, come on. Don't know if I can knock it. Dead. Okay, hold on, hold on. Eat shots here. I habitually aim for the tail. I don't need parts off of you. I keep trying to go for the belly here. Ah! I will take that. What? There's another machine up there. Says there's another spike snout up there. Gotcha. So we're looking. Knock that off. Blow that open. Knock that off. Is it down? Oh, this might kill it. Whoa! That was... Right. you are bugged out.
That's all of them. I should check the scouts.
Cool. I mean, I'm not going to say no to the AI breaking when I need it to. That? Check this. Oh, this is not a good sign for Jamal's brother.
It's no relic. Not sure if either of them are Oris. But maybe one of them dropped it as they fought off the machines?
Nope, follow the footsteps. Oh, no.
My focus might show me more. Huh. Nothing. Maybe my focus can pick up their tracks instead? There. Maybe Oris escaped the machines. Better see where it leads.
Okay. Oh no, we're going... Really? We did all of that to backtrack? Ooh, wait, are there berries over here? Alright, so we are headed in this direction. Oh, did I not highlight it? Oh, I highlighted it. I was going the right way. I guess I was supposed to start with them. That's the issue. Alright, and this was supposed to be number 2. Ah. Whoopsie, that was my fault. Where did you go, Oris?
Machine. It looks like it gave chase, but Oris fought it off.
Oris?
I can't override that machine until I find the right cauldron.
Override it yet.
It looks like he ran inside the tower. Probably to escape those sunwings up there.
Hey.
Tracks end here. He must have climbed up this tower.
Alright, up we go. Thank you. Oh. We're gonna do it at night. Just because.
That must be the tower Jomar mentioned. And it's full of sunwings. That can't be good.
Oh, are we so- That gets us to here, which gets here. This could take a few. Thought that was the way to go. Maybe not? Okay. Up. A little too dark. Ooh, loot.
Dead end. Maybe if I go outside, I can find another way up.
Hmm. Omar, you monkey crazy bastard. How did you get up here?
Nothing to see here.
Going. Oh,
another close one.
Whoopsie.
This must be Oris.
Oh.
But there's only one way to be sure. I better check for the relic.
Sorry, Jomo.
The relic. And my focus picked up data on it.
Oh?
It's not a beacon, it's a tourist map of San Francisco. If the Quen could read this, they wouldn't need to send scouts out blind. I should tell Alva.
Aloy, I'm here.
Alva, I found some data I think Bohai might be interested in seeing. I'm sending it to you now.
I'll pass it along.
Thanks. I better take this relic back with me. Give it back to Jomar. Along with the bad news.
And hopefully new equipment. We... just gonna fast travel back. I have hardly touched my teeth. Sorry. Jomar, I got bad news.
Ancestor,
give me good stuff.
Returned. Did you?
I'm sorry.
How did he die?
The tower was a Sunwing nest. He went in there looking for cover, but he was holding on to that when I found him.
On the upside.
I read the data on it. It had a map that can help your people get the lay of the land without risking more scouts. All of us sharing it with Bohai right now. It's a good thing your brother protected it.
I'd trade all the data in the legacy to have my little brother back.
How that feel? Well,
but
with my parents.
I'm glad that something meaningful came from his death. As promised, you now have access to my weapon stock. If you bring me the right resources, I can make you anything you see there. Actually, why don't you give this a try? One of our best. And if it's of use, you know where to find more.
Got a rope caster?
Thank you. I'm really sorry for your loss.
I know you are. And I'm grateful.
Well, the armor guy didn't really have any armors. Let's see if the... Elite canister, rope caster. Let's see if he has anything. Oh, maybe. Not really. Some purple corroding. Maybe. I have three of those. Go ahead and buy that. Oh, you've got...
That should help bring out your gear's full potential?
Sort of. Alright, well, it looks like the best armor and weapons are in the arena, and I'm not getting those. And we never found a way to... I'm gonna look this up. Is there a way... A way to buy green shrine in Forbidden West. Base. No, there's no way to buy it. You just gotta get lucky, I guess. Or find the right spots or something. But what are we looking at? Let me save. But yeah, certifying ropes, use canister spoons. Yeah, I never got one to work. Ah, here it is. Let me save and head to base, and we'll see what that trip. And what I will do, save this. Save this. As weird as it sounds, create a third saved game. So if these two override, and I need a backup at this point, I can get here. So let's go ahead and just head back to base. And we'll see what happens in the next 20 minutes or so. Because we'll probably be finishing up side quests and errands. And any collectibles I've done over the next few days. And then we're probably going to finish this game within the next, I don't know, I'll say 6 hours, question mark? 6 hours, question mark, or so? And go from there. Probably by this week. By Friday of this week. Well, this clocked in at almost 90 episodes. 80 episodes. Probably a little more than that. Good game. I am enjoying it. Definitely worth the money in sheer hours alone. I think they did a great job. There's a few nitpicks here and there. Keeps it at like an 8 or a 9 out of 10. Not a 10 out of 10.
It'll be this time.
We have a lot of people to talk to. Yeah. Let's talk to Kotalo first. Let's just do some talking before I trigger the next. Really? You still don't have an arc?
Aloy? Well, Matt. We've been briefed on our mission, and are ready whenever you wish to head to Cauldron Gemini.
Were you able to finish the new arm Gaia was helping you with?
Indeed. I was hoping we could discuss it, if you have a moment.
You wanted to talk about your arm?
Indeed. It's time to test it. And I want you to be there.
Okay. How are we doing this?
Not how. Where? Will you meet me where we felled Regala's Tremor Tusk? Right where the river bends?
Sure, if you want, but I'm not sure I understand.
We're hunting!
You'll see when we get there. I promise.
Then I'll let you know when I get close.
You have my thanks, Aloy.
How are your studies going?
I wanted to learn more about the world of the Old Ones.
And?
I looked up this pharaoh Gaia said you went looking for, and learned about the plague of machines he unleashed. To think that the ancient world was wiped out by a mistake. A single miscalculation. There is no glory or honor in such a fate. Only hubris and pointless death.
That about sums it up. Have you spoken with Alva?
The Quen is peculiar. Nothing like a Tanakh. Her mind is sharp, that much is certain. But it's hard to imagine her surviving in the wilds.
Trust me, she's tougher than she looks.
You'd have to be.
I will take your word for it.
Okay, so here's what we'll do.
I have to go now.
We'll talk to everyone.
Do not let me keep you.
And then we'll do all the side quests.
I'll call you when I'm close to Regala's old outpost near the bulwark.
May the ten.
I feel like if we trigger Gemini, it might trigger the end of the game. So I think we're gonna do some talking, and this will be the end of the video, and then we will head to Beta. You came upstairs, and then we will head to doing the quest. Oh no, that's Alva. Hi, Alva. Like Beta from behind.
Aloy. Right to work, I see. There's just so much. I mean, we knew of artificial beings that served the ancestors, but Gaia? Oh, she's amazing! And you, a true reincarnation of an ancestor. Genetically speaking, of course, not like the, late CEO. And there's more ancestors out there, returned from beyond the stars.
Of course, they're trying to kill us, which is not great.
Every...
And Eric Visser is with them, which is disturbing. And then there's Hephaestus, and...
Okay, okay. How about we take it one step at a time?
You're right. I also owe you an explanation.
Yes, you do!
For everything that happened at Landfall.
Alright. Start with here and work our way around. Oh, shit. Yeah.
You mentioned the reason you came here was to help your family.
A lot of lore.
Sister.
Her name is Alika. Our parents were commoners. Peasants, really. When I passed the divination exams, they were so proud. It brought honor to our family and increased rations.
Oh, I don't like that.
Alika begged me not to leave for the Research Academy.
Why? What happens there?
Alika knew that once you enter, you're not allowed to leave or see anyone. Not even your family. Unless you can get special permission and an escort by an overseer.
That sounds harsh.
Like the focuses we keep, diviners are few in number, and the Empire is, well, fearful that outsiders will try to steal our knowledge. Last time I was allowed to see my family was just before our voyage here. Because of my position, I was able to get them refuge from the floods within the capital. But if our crops don't recover soon, they'll starve to death along with everyone else.
I promise I'll do my best to make sure it doesn't come to that.
Hmm.
The ancestors, is that what your people call the old ones?
Yes and no. The ancestors are the greatest of the old ones. Those whose legacy taught us agriculture, medicine, warfare, leadership, and patronage of the science and arts.
The CEO called Elizabeth Sobek an assistant. What's that about?
Right. Well, any old one who has made minor contributions or worked extensively under one of the ancestors is called an assistant. That's how we thought of Sobek, until we met you. Our limited access to data past the late 2040s has obviously misinformed our view of the past.
Oh, at least she's willing to admit it. I wonder how the rest of society is going to take.
You said you owed me an explanation for what happened in Thebes. I'm listening.
Right. I'll start at the beginning with the CEO. He was an Imperial, the Emperor's nephew, in fact. As such, he sponsored many diviners to search the legacy for anything that might help the tribe.
Oh, that's good.
Himself.
That's bad.
He took a special interest in anything related to Ted Faro, whom we consider the greatest of the ancestors.
Oh, we need to change that.
Ted Faro, revered ancestor. That's tough to take.
I know better now, of course. Anyway, the diviners discovered that Faro spent a great deal of time in San Francisco. In fact, many of the most important ancestors did. So the Emperor's nephew convinced him that an expedition across the ocean might solve our most pressing problems. If only we could find the right data in this fabled city. Perhaps we could roll back the floods and storms that threatened our people.
Partially, right?
The Emperor declared that all the tribe's resources be poured into this endeavor. Dozens of ships were built, scouting missions were dispatched, and the Emperor's nephew was named Sio, one who wields the legacy for the good of the Empire.
Okay,
the
yeah.
The living embodiment of Ted Faro, the Renewer.
Mm.
It may seem strange now, but for a time, he carried all of our hopes. We really believed he would save us. We had no idea just how perilous the journey would be.
You said the expedition across the sea was more dangerous than you thought it would be. What happened?
We lost most of our ships to hurricanes, and scores of soldiers perished to hunger and disease. And that was before we even hit the coast. Once we landed, machines ripped our patrols apart, and we struggled to replenish our rations. There were bright spots, to be sure. We found Thebes and the greenhouse. But nothing improved the CEO's mood as his dreams of saving the tribe were slowly dashed. He became more and more obsessed with Thebes and what lay behind its door. And
madness is nightmares.
More and more convinced that the title of CEO was no mere honorific. You heard him, spouting nonsense about Pharaoh's essence and some kind of becoming. We knew these weren't the words of a sane man, but he was quick to put any who spoke out in front of a firing squad.
What a great guy.
The Quen are wrong about many things when it comes to the legacy. I can see that now. But what the CO became was a complete perversion of what principal diviners stand for. The pursuit of truth.
Okay, that's good.
I'm sorry you had to endure his madness.
So he may have been one bad apple.
For everyone.
Okay.
So, Bohai, your overseer. Will he run things better than CO?
He won't execute people on a whim, if that's what you mean. But he's hardly a paragon of integrity.
Oh,
I can't tell you how many times he took credit for data in the legacy that I uncovered. The best thing I can say about him is that he can be trusted to always do what's best for him.
Silence.
Sounds about right.
That we can deal with.
Back at the greenhouse, you spoke of knowledge forbidden to your people.
Diviners are meant to seek out the truth in the legacy. And many Imperials sponsor them in the hopes they'll find something the Empire can put to use, thus gaining favor with the Emperor. But the Board of Overseers claims certain truths are detrimental to the stability of the Empire.
Yeah.
Discovering one of our revered ancestors ended the world. That is why Diviners are only allowed to access segments of the legacy. Only Overseers can view it all. It ensures that any heretical data can be contained and retrieved before it can spread.
But who decides
what happens to diviners who break the rules?
I never had the courage to ask.
That's the problem. Anyways.
You mentioned Eric Visser. How do you know about him?
The Zenith who tried to kill you? He is known to the Quen as the Protector.
The what now?
Combing through data related to his work led us to breakthroughs related to weapons and military tactics. Knowledge our rulers used to conquer and expand, to become the empire we are today.
Okay.
That's why he's one of our most revered ancestors. But based on your encounter with him, it appears he's even more ruthless than we ever imagined. Yet another distorted interpretation in the legacy.
Yeah, it could be dangerous meeting your heroes.
At least you're piecing together the truth.
If only the overseers back home would do the same.
That's the problem.
Beta mentioned other Zeniths. Tilda, Verbena, and Gerard.
I'm afraid I don't know anything about them. Whatever legacy they left behind, the Diviners haven't recovered.
Or they're keeping it hidden. Alright, so... Wes, it could be... Because they keep referring to the Great Delta. And you wanted to say that, I guess, depending on how big your world is... So now, I am literally thinking all of... I keep saying Polynesia, I apologize. But I am thinking of just Southeast Asia. I think that is the Empire. So, what would probably now be Hong Kong, Korea, Seoul, in that area... maybe parts of Japan, but that whole area, I think that's all the Empire.
I see you've been using your new focus.
It's been fascinating. So much better than the version the Quen have. What would have taken me years to sort through, like the database you helped me recover? With this, I've been able to establish search parameters to speed up the process. This could revolutionize how diviners analyze the legacy. That is... whatever part of it the overseers would actually let us see.
That's the other issue.
You wanted data, you'll find lots of it here.
A diviner has never had this sort of unsupervised access to archives such as this. And knowing you, I suspect there is much that would normally be forbidden held within them. But I was sent here to help you. I would be remiss to ignore any truth laid before me. Maybe it'll help the Quen find their way back to the path of truth.
Alright, she's growing on me. She started kind of annoying, but I am beginning to like.
I imagine you don't know anyone here that well yet, but they're a good group.
It's funny, because one of your friends is, well, another you.
Beta!
Not that you are the same person at all. I mean, you are, as in... you're both genetically Elizabeth Sobek, But even so, you're different.
Yeah, we are. I hope everyone's been treating you okay.
Oh, yeah, of course. They've all been extremely welcoming. And they share the knowledge they learn on their focuses with each other freely. It's refreshing. Back home, diviners can only share data with the permission from the overseers.
Mm.
Sounds restrictive and stifling.
Yeah, you are not wrong.
All right.
I need to get going.
Yeah, so we'll finish the talking, because I don't think there's much talking.
All I need is to help you succeed in your mission. The plan Gaia told me about to capture Hephaestus, it will help set things right.
I hope so.
Then I will do whatever I can. I promise.
And then we'll call it a day. So let's finish up. Dr. Katala, we'll end with Beta. I don't want to talk to Gaia.
There
I feel like
is.
That will trigger Gemini.
I hear you found Thebes. How was it?
Maniacs, lava. What's not to like?
Genetic abominations.
Remember that next time I go traveling.
At least I got what we needed to trap Hephaestus.
Good thing I got my gear ready then.
You look tired.
Ha! You're never one to hold back, are you? I've just been making sure that I got everything down for this mission of yours. I wouldn't want to be the usual screw-up out there.
You'll do fine.
Fine, Aaron. Oh. I did not read that. I just said the same thing as the game did. Oh, that's good writing.
Yeah, when she's not reading the archives like a giddy kid drinking her first ale. She took to that new focus quick, that's for sure. I gotta say, I'm a little jealous. But I can see why you two hit it off.
Yeah, because this is gonna go quick.
As soon as you want us heading out to those cauldrons.
I'll give you the heads up.
From the look on your face, I'd say the mission was a success.
I got Omega clearance. Is everyone ready to head out to Cauldron Gemini?
As soon as you give the word.
I see all of us settled in nicely.
Our new Quen friend? The moment she laid eyes on the archives, she jumped on them like a long leg.
Yeah, that's Alva for you. Now that I have Omega clearance, we can grab Hephaestus and finally have the advantage over the Zeniths.
Can't wait to see their faces as they stare down a bunch of charging thunder jaws.
Better them than us, for once. Once Gaia is back up and running, I expect you to put all your training to good use.
The seeds have been planted. All they need is a chance to bloom. What? I thought that was pretty good. Zoe liked it.
Yeah, she would.
I'm glad you and Zoe found each other.
Don't forget, you're to blame for that.
I should go get this to Gaia.
Of course. Let us know when we're needed.
Then we'll try talking to... We'll talk to Zoe, then we'll talk to Beta.
Welcome back.
Good to be back. Have you met our new Quen guest yet?
I could barely keep up as she gave herself a tour of the base. Varro gave her a new focus. Though when he told her she was free to access all the data we had here, she turned so pale I thought she'd faint on the spot. We showed her to the archive room so she could see for herself. She hasn't left the place since.
Sounds like Alva. Read anything interesting lately?
I found out the old ones use leaf infusions like the Utaru do. Tea, they call it. Apparently it helped soothe them. That and some sort of scented wax they used to cleanse their aura. Plus something called bubble baths.
Oh, bubble baths are fun.
Me, I think I'll stick to singing to calm the nerves.
How are things with everyone?
Slightly quieter. Aaron's been busy scouring data on his newest obsession. Apparently the old ones wrestled machines as some kind of performance. Called it metal versus meat.
Huh.
A must-see battle between steel and flesh, as Aaron likes to put it. You'd think we have enough of that going around as it is.
Interesting. Alright.
I need to get going.
Right. You've retrieved the Omega clearance. That means we'll be going after Hephaestus soon. I'll make sure my gear is ready.
Let's go talk to Beta. Then we'll call it a day. Was there new... more stuff. Beta should... This way, question mark?
Place looks nice with some grain in it.
And dirt. Don't forget all that
downstairs. To bring in. Hey, Beta! Beta. Gaia? Why is Beta's door closed? I guess we'll find that out next.
So you play pretend on top of a table.
Wait a minute. No, okay, that's just there to look pretty. Okay. I never heard about playing pretend on top of a table. Did someone mention Dungeons and Dragons? I'm just saying. Alright, we're gonna call it here for today. Thank you for watching. We will to finish off the side quests and errands that we can do. I might do some jobs in my own time. Oh, and the Rebel Camp. And yeah, we'll return to and the Gauntlet runs, and we need to turn in. Well, I guess we can't turn in this, but we can turn in black boxes, and I can return in the relics. So we will that. Did I not do this Vista Point? Oh, I missed a Vista Point. All right, and we'll do this. And that will be our goal over the next few days, and then I guess we finish off the game? Question mark. And I guess this, for the most part, as far as armor and other such, is what we will be wearing in the final fight. So, if I get the chance, I will go ahead and hunt down some Thunder Jaws and a Dreadwing. Dear Lord. And these are just overrides. And yeah, and this stuff. And then we'll call it. I will finish the overrides. I will do all the errands. I will turn it before we finish this playthrough. I will not apparently get every thing. I will try to find every nook and cranny of this base as well. That's a maybe. But yeah, we have a path to endgame. Thank you very much for watching, as always. Feel free to like, subscribe, or comment. Sorry about the interruption during the recording session / in between question mark videos. We lost power. I don't know why. Until we see, as always, if you're enjoying the playthrough, feel free to like, subscribe, or comment. Smash that bell. Enjoying this, and I hope you are too. Even better, check out other playthroughs and videos I've done. Bestest! Come on over and check me out when I stream live. Sunday through Friday. Thank you very much for watching. Until we see each other again, but be kind. Hello, this is Gohan the Chinchilla, and we hope you're having a good day, as do I. As always, we hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, feel free to follow, like, subscribe, or comment. Or even better, come on over to twitch.tv/SparkyTDK and watch me live every Monday through Friday. Thank you for your support.